To create a procedural painted material, first start with a texture coordinate. From here, you will want to plug the generated output into two separate mapping nodes. The first mapping node will allow us to create the grunge, which will set up our base color of the material. So from the vector of the mapping node, split this into two separate noise textures. The first one from the default settings should be set to detail 14 and roughness around 0.93, and disable normalize, whereas the second one, change the detail to 15 and again disable the normalize. Then from the FAC of both, plug it into a math node set to add, then plug it into a color ramp set to linear. The color of this material is up to you. Both points should first be set the same color, with the left one at position 0 then being set slightly darker, which I usually tend to keep within 0.03. This way it doesn't stand out too unnaturally. Of the noise texture, you can change both nodes, scale, detail or roughness to get the look you want. Going back to its mapping node, you can then plug a value node into the scale so that you can change its size as shown. I set this to about 5. You can then plug the color ramp into the base color of the principal BSDF. Now, going back to the other mapping node, split this off into two more mapping nodes. I'll explain why we're doing this a bit later. The first of these new mapping nodes, once again, should be plugged into another noise texture with the value of the scale set to 25 and the detail to 0. Then that plugs into a color ramp set to ease. I set the black value to 0.65, but this can be changed depending on how many large paint splatters you want present and how large you want them. You can also change the scale of the noise to do this as well. Again, add a value node to the scale of the mapping node. This will be a common theme as it allows you to change the scale easily for each independent part. For the next mapping node, add two noise textures. The vector of the mapping node should be plugged into the scale and detail set to 2. The noise texture should then be plugged into the vector of the next noise texture from the color output. The normalize for the second noise texture should be unticked. Scale set to 6.9, detail set to 1 and roughness to 0.1. Then plug this into a color ramp set to ease. I set the black to about 0.25. This will create small paint splatters. Then duplicate this below and change the detail of that first noise to 3.2 and change the scale of the second one to 21. I then change the black slider to 0.21. This one will create even finer details of paint splatters. I then go back and plug a value node set to 100 into both of the scales of the mapping nodes so they work in tandem together. Once again, all these values can be changed to suit your preferences. Then go back to the overarching mapping node and give it a value node. And again, I set this to 16, but you can change this and it will affect all the paint splatters, big and small. Finally, the color output of the color ramps, plug them into two mix color nodes. The first set to mix, and the next set to add. From here, plug it into a bump node with the strength set to 0.2. Lastly, plug it into the normal input of the principal BSDF. Now that you've created the material, you can add more depth to it by adding imperfections such as scratches and dirt. For a basic roughness setup, you can add a color ramp from the math node of our base color setup, and using the color ramp, you can plug this into the roughness and adjust as you would like. But the reason I have left this as empty is so you can add your own imperfections such as procedural scratches and give it much more depth and experiment with changing the different settings to fit your ideal look. For example, the texture coordinate output may better serve you from the UV output. Thank you for watching, and please let me know what you're making with this material. And lastly, if you're seeing this tutorial and it's a new version and it's no longer version 4, you can always download this older version, create the material, and then just open the material once you've saved it on the new version, and it should hopefully upgrade to that newer version. That means this tutorial is still useful if you go through that method.